Sup, bitches? Just kidding, I won't start it like that. What's up, everybody? Hope you're having a good Wednesday. There's not going to be a vlog today because I literally didn't do anything but what you're watching here. But I do have a pretty cool video, at least I think it's pretty cool, on Friday. Hopefully, if everything goes as planned, if I'm actually capable of doing it, then it'll be dope. So today we're just going to make a beat. And I downloaded a bunch of little like one-shot samples from the site I use called Splice. So they're pretty dang. So we have a bunch of new things to play around with. Actually, you know what? I think we're just going to throw this rain in here already. Let's... I will kill you. What the hell key do we want? And obviously we're gonna have a minor song if we've got that background rain. I really want to get like a city sounds pack, so it's just like city sounds looping. Oh wow, that actually worked out a lot better than I thought. Let's see if it actually works out sound-wise. Now, what we're gonna do is we are gonna clone this guy. And just instead of a reed organ, we're just gonna give it like an actual like classical grand piano. That's what I was trying to think of. I'm gonna slap all these guys down. Copy that over. And then all this stuff. Let's just throw this guy and see what happens here. Maybe we can stick this on the downbeat. That might be cool. Let's throw him like halfway through each of these little... until the actual music starts to happen. Yeah, we'll use that guy. And then let's figure out how the hell we want to This only took me 28 minutes, so I'll actually show you guys how I mix and EQ everything as well. Because normally, basically, if I was going to try and turn this into a full song, I would like kind of like add some build up around here, this point right here, and then probably like a drop would happen right here. But these aren't meant to be me making entire songs because A, that takes a lot more time. I'm very picky about the sounds I use. If even one sound that is hardly noticeable, if I don't like it, then, and assuming my dumbass notices it, if I don't like it, then I'll go in and change it. And sometimes that requires even like changing up like the whole melody. Not the whole melody, but like switching up a note or two in it in order to, you know, fill in for that sound. And anyways, so these videos are definitely not me making full songs. So just an FYI, that is why I won't be putting a drop in here or something. I don't know, if you guys want to see me do some kind of put a drop in, then I mean I'll do it. Now for this boo bass, we really want like the mid-range frequencies to stick out a little more. So I mean, I like the way that sounds. Hear it on headphones that don't have a lot of bass in them. Even if it is just a mid bass, so I mean, you'd probably be able to hear it anyways, but it's always good to just amp a little bit up in those mid-range frequencies. All right here. What we want to do is take this kick and we want to sidechain. Son of a bitch. Sidechain it to this track. And then we want to go up in here. And we want to add a limiter. Set it to compressor mode. Make it compress with the clicky click clacky. Up the ratio, up the knee, down the threshold, and so I've got everything EQ'd, sidechained, whatnot. We can go through, and so this ring needs to. Oh, also, I don't like turning anything down in this. I only did it because we're in the middle of it or working on it, and I hadn't had it in the mixer yet, but. Yeah, I like to mix it everything this way. That's kind of my process as I do everything. Now I'm just gonna export it, edit it. If you like the content, go ahead and throw me a like, a comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching. Love you guys. I will see you on Friday. Clear out smoke. I don't want the people to know that I'm vaping.